So we are looking at November 2020. Five B. November 2020, 5B. So the question says, NH is an industrial applicant which is formed by subjecting certain crude chemicals to two successful processes. The output of process one is passed to process two, where it is blended with other chemicals. The process cost for the month of April 2020 was false. So we are given that general rights for the month of April amounted to 35,700 and is absorbed into the process cost based on paper, on process paper. The normal output of process one is 80%, while that of process two is 90%. Waste matter from process one is sold for shillings 20 per kg, or that from process two is sold for shillings 30 per kg. The output for the month of April was false. There was no stock or work in progress at either the beginning or end of the period. Okay. So first of all, let's get for the general overhead. For the general overhead, the OER will be budget overhead. Budget overhead costs, you divide it by budget labor costs. And this is that 5,700 divided by process one and labor of 12,000. Process two has labor of 8,400. So this one we can multiply by 100. One seventy-five percent. Thus, process one has absorbed overhead. Thus, absorbed overhead in process one, there will be 175% of 12,000. In process two, it will be 175% of 8,400.
Forty-seven hundred. 14,700.
Okay. So based on that now, we can do process one count. We have details. We have units. We have unit costs. We have amount. Details. Units, unit costs, and amounts. This is process one counts. So that see, we have materials. So material is big as units at 75,000. We have labor, which is just 12,000. Then we have process time. Now this process time, because they are hours, you are supposed to argue like this, 12 times 2 hours. It's just like an overhead or like another labor. 4 hours. Then bring the overheads. In the overheads, which already we have determined as 21,000. Then we go to the other side where we need the normal loss. The normal loss of 20%. Because you are told the input is 50%. So that means the loss was 20%. So 20% of 3,000 is how many units?
600.
And then, according to information 3, we are told each is sold for 24. Each is sold for 24, so that must be 12,000. 12,000. Then, the amount or the units that now we brought to process 2. Is 2,300. So that tells you we have an abnormal what? Abnormal loss of 110. So we have abnormal loss of 100. That means that the unit cost down there should be
And all this costs 1,2,000. You less the 12,000, which is supposed to divide by 3,000 minus 600. The normal cost. Wow. 8, 50. So with that, this one I multiply by 50. The degree I think multiplied by 50 is 1. And 15 now. And here multiplied by 50, you get 5,000. That account has balances. So we now go process to account. Where we have details. We have units, we have unit costs, and amount. Details, units, unit costs, and amount. So ASA is this which is coming from process one. So say process one, you made it at 2,350. It was 115,000, 115,000. Then we start recording. There is these ones we call them added materials, eh? Or just materials. You can still call them just added or added because they have the units 2,000, and each is valued at 40. So this is 80. 8,000. Then we have metallurgy rebar of 8,400. We have process time. Process time will be 20 times 13, 50. And 27,000. Then we have overheads. Overheads, we got to the bottom, is 14,700. So from there, we have no loss. No more loss, which is 10% of for the 300. Because now you have two of them. That's for that. 430. And each is being sold at that for 12,100. Then the ones that are finished, it is 4,000. So that means you have an abnormal gain. Abnormal gain of that units. So with that unit cost. Equal to, you add all these costs. The other cost is all this, Nakita? 245,100. You minus 12,900. You divide by 4,300 minus 4,000. So 60 times 30, that is 1800. And 60 times, that's 240. So now growth other three accounts. I just want to confine you to the normal format. But I told you see Azima. So now let's just go come up in the normal format. The abnormal gain account. no more in accounts. So for the abnormal gain, we just have one entry. Just have one entry, and the credit in the debit in the process too. So you go to the debit as the credit side here, and you see code of process too. There is an abnormal gain of 30, 60, that is at 1800. Now, this one to close it, you can either close it as balance carry down or you take it to PNL. So, if you are taking it to PNL, we have that units. But as I told you, these units are not important, you don't balance. What is important in this case, the losses account, are the amounts. Are the amounts. So draw another one, now call it abnormal loss. Actually, go two more, abnormal loss, and abnormal loss, two more accounts. Abnormal loss, and abnormal loss accounts.
Discussion. is in the disguise. And then now, when you're born, we believe in the discussion. Someone around it. If any we get, that's it.
Y aquí con la gente.
Sorry, we are friends, Jack. So for the abnormal loss, you see this is coming from process one. Is that so? It was happening with what they put?
Process
100. Valued at 50.
Yeah.
So far, the legal usual goes to PML, 100 units, and 5,000. Then for the normal loss, accounts, process one, you put a normal loss, yeah.
600,
each value that 20, so this was 12,000. Process two, it had 430. The normal loss, each value that 30, so that gives us 12,900. So to the PNL. Now, this one you may not be able to know how to get the cost, but the key thing is just that it's about 24,900. And if you wish, you can show the average cost. Okay? You have to appear in 10,000. Then you divide this by this. But there's no need. The key thing here is just the amount cost. So we are with that. Okay. So it's in 4 million. So question 4B reads that the fund are limited by these segments. The income statement below for the segments imply that the company will improve profitability if segment X is eliminated. So we are given that the general fixed overhead related to the salary of the chief officer. Which has been allocated equal to the segment. The advertising expenses are specific to the individual segments. So prepare a comparative income statement or income statement for the company as a whole under the two alternatives, that is when X is retained and when X is eliminated. And then you advise. There is advice. prepare our teeth. So this is income statement. Or statements. For the company. And segment X is James in details. Statements of the company in segment X is James. When it is limited. So we can have our figures and thousands. Figures and thousands. So details. So you begin with sales. When you retain something or someone, everything remains as it is currently. So we will have 87 plus 210 plus 200. When you retain, that is what happens. But if you drop X, the sales of X will not be there. So we just have 210 plus 200. That is 4. Cost of goods sold. Now the question has not mentioned that we are buying a whole mountain, but the fact that down there you can see there is contribution margin, that should tell you those costs are valuable. Because contribution margin is obtained after reducing variable costs of sales. So 67. Plus 82 plus 85. And because these are variable costs, they will go. Variable costs will go with 182 plus 85. 167. And sales commission is also a variable cost. So sales commission, we will have 12 plus 22 plus 24. Then 22 plus 20 is 42. So based on that, let's now get the contribution. Subtract those so that you get contribution margin. Nabaza? 209. Then, fixed overheads. Now, fixed overheads, they are 20 plus 20 plus 20, that is 60. And according to information one, we are told those are salaries of the CEO. And because the CEO is not going anywhere, they remain. And the fact that we are not made to a general, that tells you they should remain. If they were not specific, come in as one to general, meaning where drop or rather make or buy. If they are called specific, that when they go with that department goes. But general in me. So therefore, they have 20 plus 20 plus 20, 60. Then advertisements. Advertisements. It is 6 plus 18. That is 24. But you see now, though the advertisements are fixed, they are called specific. You can see according to information two, the advertising expenses are specific, meaning they will only be there when that department is there. So if that is the case, we only have 18 here, which you bring here. So based on that, we should now be able to get our net profit. $125. So what do you advise? Should we pay or we should drop? We should pay or eliminate. Eliminate. What would you mean, Adalia?
Net profit.
Yes. So
we should retain.
Yes. Why?
Because the profit is higher.
The profit is. You know, different decisions are made depending on what, or if you are looking at different things.
If I may ask, can it be asked like a you are the net maybe it's an employer or something.
Yes.
And the method is just the same.
The same for
my ex is a net and the employer can say things. Come on, as I can do that.
You do at you do both at once. If you are eliminating two of them, yeah? If you could have another director finance and just one. Don't have a director need instead of three. So if you are moving two, then you just need one. Or whatever number they are. The concept is the same. The key thing is to a which cost are value, those ones we go with whatever you need, and the cost which are as possible. But the general fixed ones, they play. That's all. It's the same concept. You are not in class, you need to do that.
No, we need to attend to that.
No, this diagram. It may answer last week.
Yeah. It was on a Monday.
3B. Okay. I thought we saw it. So September 2015, question 4. That should be 4 B. Yeah. Still.
3B.
Question 3B. This one. Maybe you should not be asking about B. Okay. Unless you want me to receive as concerned. This one. But it's okay. Looking towards men, I can understand. We told you we are getting to you, five of us. You don't know the amount. Okay, so the following course data is available for books of a canteen. Eh? So we have meat is 100 kgs each at 250. So you only pesa ngapi? 5,000. Eggs 72 trays. Each at 200. Hmm? 40,400. Vegetables. Vegetables, we had 200 kgs at 50. I stand up. Bread. We have 200 at 52.5. 10,500. Rice of 150 kgs at 100. Things you do now. Maize flour. It is 25 bins at 1200. That is out. For the salaries, we have cooks, two of them, each at 25,000. That is 50,000. Eh? We have the crack. One crack at 15,000. Then we have the helpers.
5, each at 10,000. That is with about manager. One times 18,000. Consumables. Stores, 50,000 per month. Gas and electricity is 12,000 per month. Overheads. Allocated to the canteen. So this would be 18,000 divided by 12. Because this is per annum. 15,000. Then we have subsidy. Subsidy is 14,900. So with that, we get total costs and then we get cost per meal. $279,800. So that's to pay $279,800. You divide by the meals. The meals are 500.
$329,800. So you divide by 25.
So what we need to do is this is very robust.
If you want, we are good, but we shouldn't have it.
Yeah, that is how I do it. Like, you want to make it.
Finally, you can hear that.
Yeah.
Same thing. Same thing. Anything else? November 2019. It's your 2A. 2B. Okay. So in November 2019, question 2B. That question is also on service question. It's also on service question. So Safari Tours and Travel operates tourist travel services in the game parks around South Africa. The company is in the process of purchasing a tour van. The following details relating to the van are provided. So we have the cost of the van, the trading, the spare parts, the maintenance, the vehicle prices, the insurance. The company purchases petrol barrels at cost of that, the average mileage. So you're told to do a set you for mileages of okay. So we have details.
are supposed to do 5,000 kilometers or miles, 10,000 kilometers. We are supposed to do 5. So we will give them 30,000. That's 5, 10, 15,000 kilometers. So it's just a little bit rough. Kilometers. So as I told you, we began with fixed costs. In the fixed costs. So the fixed costs is, first of all, I told you when you see the cost of the money, that speaks of position. So we have to bring the position here. And based on this question, precision appears like a variable of forces depending on kilometers. So the precision we can treat it in two ways. Precision, you can treat it in two ways. The first way is when you can take it as fixed. And when you take it as fixed, it will be like this. We say all our figures are in thousands, it will work. All our figures are in thousands. Then we will need to say 5,500 minus the trading value of 1,500. This one we divide by 2. You divide by 2. You do that. You see, when you treat it that way, it is a fixed cost because it's raining constant time. Yeah, but if you are charged in the basis of kilometers, it will be more of a variable cost because you're changing the kilometers. As in, instead of dividing here by 2, you can divide by 60,000 kilometers. Then you have to do a differentiation per kilometer. So to put down to the multiply like kilometers. But the best way is to take it as fixed cost. So that is the normal model.
The next fixed cost that you can see you see maintenance is not depending on the kilometers. Eh? So we bring maintenance. Maintenance, we are told it is every 6 months. And it's costing us 60. So that means in a year, we will do 2 times. So 60 times 2, that is 120. License. It's also a fixed cost per year, 80. Then, insurance, we have 150. It's very good. So then total and we call it here. So it's 350, the same as the margin. Yeah? It has now have variable costs. Variable costs. So variable costs, we have spare parts. Spare parts, we are told it is per 1,000 kilometers, 20. So that were 5 divided by 1 times 20. That would be 100, eh? Then 10 divided by 1 times 20, that is 200. 15 divided by 1 times 20, that is 300. 30 divided by 1 times 20 is 600. So we will begin to go to my own and in petrol. So petrol is 1900 per barrel. And the average mileage per barrel is 25 kilometers. So what you shall be doing, itakuwa hapa unasema 5,000 divided by 25 times 1900. So that be
yes.
Then 10,000 you divide by 25 times 1900.
Maybe what I should have done is to remove these doubts of them so that they don't confuse us. Because our figures are thousands. So that not really wonder why we are. Then this is 15 divided by 25 multiplied by 1900. So that is all. So come here for load 10. Then down there, Nigeria now, we get to where we have total costs. So this total will be arrived at as A plus B, and we call it C.
On its own line, because it's just one figure. There are four of them, so I need four spaces.
Haya, hii ya kwanza we take that. Okay, then per kilometer. Costs per kilometer. Cost per kilometer, we will have fixed. So fixed, it will be 23.50 divided by 5. That gives us?
470.
2350 divided by 10. Do that five, eh? 2350 divided by 15. 156.7. 2350 divided by 30. 78.3. So that is the variable. The fit. Then we come to variable. Variable in the void divide by 5. Number 10?
96.
Then 960 divided by 10. You get 96. 1440 divided by 15. 2880 divided by 30. 96. And total should be 2830 divided by 5. 566. 3310 divided by 10. 3.1. 3790 divided by 15. 252.7. Then 5230 divided by 30. 174. 0.3. And one thing you should notice are two things relating to the fixed cost and variable cost. Fixed cost, ikikuwa kwa toto, inakuanga constant. Naona hivyo? Lakini ikiwa by unit, inabadilika. Fixed cost, ikiwa expressed as toto, huwa change. That's okay. And the opposite is true for the variable. Variable is equal to the total when you are making it. Again, it is because there are questions that I try to bring, and they tell you to comment. So, can do a comment to do that? How it feels to say. the fixed when total is constant, but per unit or per kilometer it changes. The variable for the totals it changes, and per unit means constant. Anything else? May 22. So 2C. This one is a normal effect. Q Limited manufactures a single product and uses absorption costing method. The following data relates to the performance of the entity during the month. We have the profit, we have absorbed. The non-production of fixed opening inventory closing. Units of inventory are valued at 9,000 each, consisting of variable and fixed. All overheads are fixed. Determine the actual production overhead cost for the month and compute the profit that we have reported in April 2018 if Q had used marginal cost. So this is overhead and reporting methods. Reporting methods. So as usual, when you see reporting methods, always to you, you should be quick, number one, to establish the units cost, which is marginal. Then you will come to FOAR, then you come to absorption. Then after that, you should also be very quick to establish what we call the stock schedule, where you have details and then units. These details, we always begin with the opening. Stock, we have production, we raise sales so that we get something called closing stock.
Okay, so let's look at the information that has been provided. So we are told units of inventory are valued at 9,000 each, consisting of variable cost of 3,000. So the marginal is 3,000. And the fixed of 6,000. So that tells you the OER is what? 6. So that we have absorption 3 plus 6. That gives us what? The 9,000 we are talking about. The 9,000 we have mentioned. The next thing is that we are told the opening inventory is 144 million. So take 144 divided by 9. Those are the units. Closing stock is 162,000 divided by 9 because they are valued at 9. 18,000. And then we are told product sales were 48,000. So how do you get production? Is it 18,000? You add back 48. No. You less?
16.
You get 50,000. So, so we are told over absorbed overheads. So how do we get over absorbed overheads? How do we get over absorbed overheads? Mr. Kubuka. Analysis of overheads. What do you call it? What do you call it? Absorbed. Then we less the actual. So this gives us the over or the under. Now over. Based on this, because over the money is absorbing over the top action. Naturally, it's a question of like incomplete records. And when you come up a question that is incomplete, unapanga tu venye tunapangana kama tuko na kila kitu. So hivi ndio so kama ni hivyo huwa tunapanga, how do we compute the absorbed? The absorbed we get the OER, which we know it's 1,000, we multiply by the production, the units that are produced, the actual production, times 50.
I don't know whether I put it still in thousands. How many make it out? What do you want? Okay, then give me that. So that we say our figures are in thousands. So actually you are 3. Like you need to make you are absorbed. Over-absorbed is what? Over-absorbed is 24,000. Yeah. So over-absorbed is 24,000. So how do you get the actual? The actual then should be 300,000 minus 24,000. That is 217. So I'm not quite. Then to now you are compute the profit that would have been reported if they have used what? Maybe we can try to use the absorption cost. I'm about to go to the computer. So marginal cost. Income statement. In our figures and thousands. So we know so well that we always begin with what? Sales. So when you begin with sales, sales we are told to 720,000. Then you say less opening stock. Opening stock. Now, in this case, the opening stock is 16,000. So it is 16, each value at 3,000. Then you bring production. Production, we know it is 50 each value that we have. $150,000. Closing stock is 18 each value that we have. 15. 4,000. So based on that, we get the figure known as cost of sales. $144,000. So that based on that, we get a figure known as gross contribution.
gross contribution is 576,000. After that, you know we should raise the variable non-production. Lakini swali haina variable non-production. So that is also our contribution. So less variable non-production costs. Non-production costs. I think Jules, we came across a question that is about when you are multiplying by the units. So now that he has it, you can just put it there at zero. So that we get net contribution. So net contribution will be 576,000. Then you say less fixed costs. Less the fixed cost. So fixed cost, I told you we have two types, mainly for production. So production is just one, the overhead term. Now here, here is the other action. Marginal is the other action. Marginal is this action. So the actual is 276. Then, let the non-production. Non-production, we are told they are 275,000. So put here 275,000. So in so doing, you should be able now to report the net profit. I don't think there is a need to draw the absorption because the only difference that we are, how much, sorry? What do you think? It was all right. So let's now do the reconciliation. So at that point, your examiner is going to attack us, but we can confirm whether we are right by checking whether those two profits are right. We don't agree, something is wrong. So let's draw the reconciliation. Statement. Reconciliation statement. There is a very high likelihood they will bring a question of reporting method. Very high. I'm not saying it's a must. So the reconciliation, we always give the marginal profit. Marginal profit is 25,000. Then we say less opening stock difference. Opening stocks difference. And the opening stocks difference, how are to me 48,000? 144,000. That's a difference. 96,000. You don't go to the side here because it's already catered for. Yeah. Then you add closing thoughts. Difference. So how are closing stock? How are the 64 bars? Now I'm making a point that we are 162 bars. So a difference of? 1 weight. So you have less. So if everything is okay, and it should, then we should have absorption profit. And the absorption profit is what we have to need. That's $7. Check whether that is true. Yes. So we then call it at the other juncture. On your own, you can try your question forming, another question forming matchup. So we call it at the other juncture.